Today it's the era of entrepreneurs. Everyone wants to become an entrepreneur. How many of you want to become entrepreneurs? Wow, see, I am not bad. Every engineering student wants to become an entrepreneur. From where you get ideas. NASCOM has an event saying that 10,000 startup ideas. 10,000 startups. Do you have that many ideas? Most of them, they start, like Flipkart is successful, I'll have one more e-commerce site. You look for ideas. They may be just around the corner. You don't even know that there is an idea just behind you, unless you come across a pain point of someone. When you see a pain point of someone, it's an opportunity for you to start the company. Nobody will give you an idea. You have to find an idea. Traditionally, bigger is better was the approach. You have a huge idea. You think that one particular idea will make you a billionaire overnight. No, these things are running out of steam now. You have to be careful because funding is not available as easily as you used to get earlier. Now, every one of you have seen this Jugaad. Jugaad brings a smile on your face, right? Very simple. I don't have a birth. I don't need to pay even 100 rupees. All I need is one bed sheet. Request somebody, chota adjust kar lo bhai. Ho gaya. This gentleman wanted a drip irrigation system in his rooftop. But no, sorry, can't. The pumping is a problem. Everything is a problem. He found IV fluids is a simpler solution. This is what? A beautiful piece I always wanted. I said, I am either in the... This is a classic case where I actually even I asked LG guys, boss, I am either in my hall or in a bedroom. I am not in both the places. Give me one external unit and give me two indoor units. These civil mechanical guys, I don't know how they can't manage one simple switch. Electronic guys, you can give switch, right? Mechanical guys can't give me a switch between two indoor units. Very sad. This chap has found a very good innovative idea where he can have one, both are one, and he has enjoying two rooms. This is a very interesting case where this has been studied by some countries, how Jugaad actually helps a lot of rural innovations. Not only this, if you see rural innovation, there are so many equipment have been manufactured by the farmers in Punjab. You'll be surprised. In some cases, where to reap the harvest, sometimes they put a fan, regular fan to blow out the husk. So these things are very, very innovative. Every Jugaad idea brings a smile, thinking that it's a joke, but actually it is actually solving somebody's purpose. What is problem in Jugaad? Jugaad, it serves the purpose, but it doesn't give you a quality. And most of the time, you cannot repeat. You have seen the air conditioner thing. Would you put it? Your wife will kill you. I would love to have this, but she will kill me. This one, of course. Now what happens? Now there's a time to change your thinking. How Jugaad can be implemented much better? Adding a quality. That is where frugal comes in. Frugal is the idea of where you design it well with a quality and you save time and energy. And frugal is basically you do a lot of stuff by doing more with less. This particular case, what happens, everything, you have to trim down what is not required. Many times people think frugal means it is cheap. It is not cheap. It is sometimes some investments are required. And many times they think it's a low technology. Frugal means low technology. No, frugal uses high technology at lower cost. How do you reduce the cost? We can always study the system. That is what I was telling. How if you think money, you are saving money, it is not cheap. If you are talking about long term, then it is frugal. If you are thinking money is more than relationships, it is not frugal. This is a case where I think this is the earliest instance of a frugal innovation where one empty soap box went into the market. This everybody would have heard about this. How did the soap box go out of the stringent manufacturing quality control steps? It went. It means there is a lack of some solution somewhere. So they tried different things. Finally, they came out with a simple fan which will just blow away the soap box. It serves the purpose. So this is where you identify a solution with thinking small. My entire thinking on this topic is basically think small. Don't think big. Gatamila, they have water problem, Peru, Nepal. They have drinking water problem. How do you provide drinking water in those areas, the hilly areas? They realize the fog is, they have a heavy, dense fog every night. So the United Nations funded project, they actually erected the huge screens, fog screens, which will collect the fog. When the fog hits the screens, it converts into a water, and they found that it is a potable water, people can drink it. The whole thing is stored in the ground level, and then that can be used anywhere else. Again, Maya Pedals Gatamela. This Gatamela seems to be doing a lot of stuff, though it's a small company. Why I am talking about Gatamela is, which is a small country, they cannot afford actually high technology. They have to leverage low technology, which can help their citizens. And this Maya Pedals, one small company, they requested the countries like United States and Brazil. They supplied them the container loads of cycles which they are not being used in those countries. And this company converts those cycles into usable gadgets, like you pedal it and then make it a grinder. And as well as you can use the pumping systems. Same Gatamela has one more system where they use bamboo to make cycles. They don't use any steel. That way they are actually protecting even the environment. Using the bamboo as the fabrication facility, they make the cycles. This is very innovative project taken up by India in a large scale. This canal top solar project, which is started in Gujarat, in barely 750 meter stretch, you can produce 1 megawatt of solar power, clean solar power. And land acquisition is generally the cost, that is a major issue in any solar projects. And in this, in a single slot, they have removed the land acquisition cost. At the same time, they are able to preserve the water evaporation. Wow. Ah, how many of you have not given missed calls? This is the innovation given by India to the world. No mobile company ever thought this is a feature in a mobile phone. We have been thinking that it's used only for calling people. If somebody is actually going from home to office, the son will reach the office. From there, he'll give a missed call to the mother. Mother knows the son has reached, not anywhere else. Maybe that is useful for all these college students to give a missed call to mothers. And nowadays, even the missed call is being used for corporate purposes. Now this has actually become a feature of a mobile phone. Your customer care, your refrigerator is not working, they'll say, please give a missed call to this number. So Indians, we think ahead of everyone else. This is another interesting somebody said I am giving too many examples, but unfortunately frugal, unless you tell them what are the examples, you don't understand what is the idea of that. One company they found, he was working from one of the colleges here, and they found no final year engineering student ever shares the notes with anybody else. It's a secret data because he will lose marks if others also copy the same. So he took out the handwritten notes of the student of the previous topper, previous year topper, put it onto a CD. The handwritten notes scanned and put onto a CD, and then every student bought it. He was thrilled with that idea. Next year he put that as an electronic text and then sold it. Again it was successful. Third year he converted that into, he compiled 3 or 4 toppers together, he created an electronic content, and then again it went on well. And finally the company has been sold to a multinational company. So this way, he found out that there is a small idea which can convert into your business. Engineering student notes, handwritten notes, can you imagine that it has become an idea of a company which has been acquired by another multinational? So that is why I keep telling, keep thinking small. You don't need to think for huge ideas. Idea is next to you. This is another floating form, which is an idea of some young guy. Maybe he's in his early 20s. He found that the containers which are being shipped from China to different countries are coming back to China empty. So he created a small pad where you can water automatically and with a small drip irrigation sort of system. And just after the container is free, you put that pads and then start watering and the ship sails back to China. By the time the container reaches China, the entire container has a sort of vegetables or fruits or whatever it is, which can be grown in that 2 months or 3 months time. So this is a typical ideas of frugal. In healthcare, every one of us, we know how expensive is healthcare. GE has come out with an ultrasound machine which costs just $500. Just $500, which is a portable device, and you can take it to a rural area, you can just do scanning, whatever. After this, one Indian company has come out with a portable ECG machine, and this is becoming a new area for all entrepreneurs who can think small and provide good facilities in the healthcare. Jaipur Foot. I don't know how many people have heard, many people have not heard about Jaipur Foot. But this is Jaipur Foot is one of the oldest device which our people have designed. If anybody has an amputated leg, they would customize a foot for them and then they used to fit it. This is being given free of cost by so many people in Jaipur and all over India. This I don't call it, people used to call it as a Jugaad, but I don't think it is a Jugaad. It is basically a frugal, very well thought over plan. It is basically a customize the foot for the person, length of the foot, width of the foot, everything they calculate and design it for the individual. It's not one size fits all type. The frugal innovation, only the problem is we actually don't know what is frugal, which idea is frugal, what actually saves. There is one thing called cost innovation. So in cost innovation, is a typical example is Nirma. Unfortunately, I have to give the examples. Nirma does the same thing what Surf does at a fraction of the cost. They are giving you the same functionality at the lower cost. How they managed, that is the beauty of that particular company. If you say good enough innovation, Tata Nano, of course, when they started, not now. Now Tata Nano is 6 lakhs, I don't buy it, I buy something else. So when they started, they cut off all the features which are not wanted. You want 4 wheels, 2 seats, 1 steering wheel, a clutch, accelerator, brake, enough, done. That way you can cut down the cost. But unfortunately, it didn't work that way. That's a different issue. But you have to think how you can change the entire scenario. Focus, basically, sometimes what happens is you do a new functionality at a lower cost. That is the typical of our canal top solar project, what I have been discussing. Major problems with frugal is we don't have a knowledge. We don't know what is next to you. Every one of us, I have been telling, think simple. You ask me, okay, give me a simple solution. I can't give you. You have to find your own solution. And second example is, who needs it? You take a case of ultrasound machine which has been manufactured by GE for $500. They knew very well ultrasound machines are pretty expensive. Only the major hospitals can afford. Small people can't afford. Who are the small people? Is it a doctors? Is it a small clinics in the villages? But still they went ahead and then they found that this has a huge acceptance across the world. There are so many countries, so many area villages, you cannot send an ultrasound machine, and probably this ultrasound machine is useful. That is how we actually work under the concepts of think small. How do you facilitate frugal? Right now, somebody should tell this is the segment which they need this kind of equipment. If you go to Punjab, you find lot of farm equipment designed by the farmers and used by themselves. If somebody can see those, convert them into a regular equipment, it would have been a phenomenal device. We have seen people using just motorcycles to plow their fields instead of using the cattle. They devise one small plow and then tie it to the bike and then just do it. Can somebody actually make it as a separate equipment? These things somebody should say. And what kind of ideas come out? Maybe the NGOs who are very close to the grassroots level people, they should be able to give you the concepts of which product is needed by whom. Similarly, somebody should actually, even if you get an idea, you don't know how to execute. Suppose you want to enter into healthcare. You should know which item is actually needed by the rural or semi-urban, where the demand is there. So try it, like somebody has already done for ECG machine. You can do something else, like X-ray machines. We have no clue how an X-ray machine works, whether can you do it. If you cannot do it, drop it. There could be some other things which, like recently one more blood testing thing has come where in a small chip is embedded into the entire equipment. You just drop one blood drop on that particular chip. It gives you an entire history of all the parameters, whatever you measure in blood, in 15 minutes. The entire process takes about 15 minutes by the embedded chip, which will give you a complete report. Food tech, one gentleman, what he thought, he wanted to be an Airbnb of food. He thought so many women at home, they cook beautiful food, I mean, fantastic recipes they have, and each woman can cook in a different way. Why can't we make housewives sell their own cooked food? So he actually became a aggregator of all the women who can cook. He launched a website. It did very well in the beginning. If somebody wants to have Punjabi lassi in Bangalore, you know some woman who is Punjabi giving the Punjabi lassi. Fine, it was working well. But after they got even funded $1.72 million. Then they found the quality is not uniform across. With that, entire concept of the Airbnb concept has crashed. Because his idea was good. Nothing wrong with the idea. To leverage the entire people, the local community, and provide them what kind of food they want to eat. So it is not easy to execute. Idea is simple, but execution is very, very critical. No one tells you what is frugal. You should know what it is. Think small. Your idea only has to be there. Think how you can implement it. It can be a low cost, but it should serve the purpose. And you should have a great reach. If you don't have a great reach, again, there is no point in making any business. At the end of it, it's business. Thank you.